Hello everyone! Good morning, good afternoon, and good evening. Happy weekend sa inyong lahat. I hope you are all doing well. Kamusta na? Welcome sa ating community ng Pinoy Survivor. Welcome to the channel. Video number 122. So tuloy lang natin yung pinanggalingan natin sa sinulat ng Supreme Court. Like, share, subscribe. Comment lang kayo sa baba. Kayo magbigay ng usga ninyo sa ating korte. So, as to the Honor Committee Executive Session / Chambering, may sinabi rin yung korte natin, Suprema. Petitioners narrate that there was an irregular administrative hearing in the case of Cadet First Class Arcadio, si Jack, because two voting rounds took place. Dalawa daw, sabi ng Korte Suprema. After the result of the secret balloting, Cadet First Class Khan ordered the voting members to go to the room without cadet recorders. Therein, the lone dissenter, Cadet First Class Laglag, was asked to explain his not guilty vote. Pressured to change his vote, he was made to cast a new one, finding Cadet First Class Arcadio guilty. The original ballot was discarded and replaced. There was no record of the change in vote from 8-1 to 9-0 that was mentioned in the Honor Committee formal report. So, yun yung sinasabi ng mga petitioner, meaning yung mga magulang, no? Nag-petition sila sa korte, tsaka yung PAW, lawyers. So, yan yung sinasabi nila. Okay. The affidavit of Commander Somebody, sabihin ko siya, Somebody, yung nag-report si Major Nobody. Ito ngayon, ang nagko-comment, si Commander Somebody. Executed on March 6, 2018, was submitted by petitioner since he purportedly recalled Cadet First Class Laglag tell him that he was pressured to change his not guilty vote after the voting members were chambered. In the sworn statement, Commander Somebody said, isa siya dun sa mga testimonya na pinangahawakan ng mga lawyer para kay Cadet Jack Arcadio. Totoong pimeyer to. Ay, saludo ko sa kanya, Commander. Kasi, he put his career on the line, no? Para lang sabihin yung totoo. Nag-apidabit nga eh. Okay. Sabi niya, number one, that Cadet First Class Jack Arcadio was convicted for honor violation. I cannot remember exactly the date, but sometime in the morning of the 23rd or 24th of January 2018, I was in my office filling up forms for the renewal of my passport. Siguro mag-schooling abroad, ano? Cadet First Class Laglag entered and had business with my staff. Okay. Number two, when he was about to leave, I called him, Lags. Oh, Cadet Laglag talaga, Lags. Halika muna rito. And he approached me and I let him sit down on the chair in front of my table. I told and asked him, talagang nadali si Jack. Ano ba talaga ang nangyari? Magtagalog or magbisaya ka? He replied. Si Cadet Lags replied, "Talagang not guilty ang boat ko sa kanya, sir." And I asked him, "Oh, bakit naging guilty? Di ba pag may isang not guilty, absuelto na?" Si Cadet Laglag nag-reply, Chinamber ako, sir. Bale, pina-justify kung bakit not guilty ang boat ko. At na-pressure din ako, sir, kaya binago ko, sir." So, sabi ni Commander somebody, "Sayang siya, matalino at mabait pa naman." And he replied, "Oo nga, sir," sabi ni Cadet Laglag. After that conversation, I let him go. So, yan yung apidabit ni Commander somebody na inaamin ni Cadet Laglag sa kanya na parang marites-marites, no? Walang maingay, marites. Tayo-tayo lang ba? Real talk lang. Balita ko, nag-guilty si Cadet Jack. Ano ba talaga nangyari? "Oh, sir, nag-guilty. Pero ako yung nagboto na not guilty." Paano yun? O, diba? Tapos, pin-explain si Cadet Laglag na chamber kasi siya. Na-pressure siya. So, okay, go on. Move on. "It is claimed that the Honor Committee gravely abused its discretion when it committed voting manipulation since, comma, under the rules, comma, it is required to have a unanimous 9 votes finding an accused cadet guilty." So, yun yung sabi ng mga lawyer para kay Cadet Jack. "Claim that the Honor Committee gravely abused its discretion when it committed voting manipulations." Okay. Ang requirement, 9 votes na guilty. Okay. "There is nothing in the procedure," nada, "nothing in the procedure that permits the Honor Committee chairman to order the chambering of a member who voted contrary to the majority and subjects him or her to reconsider in order to reflect a unanimous vote. Neither is there an order from the Chief of Staff or the President sanctioning the Honor Committee procedure or approving any change therein pursuant to Sections 30 and 31 of CA number 1. The Honor Committee, the club, and the PMA violated their own rules and principles as embodied in the Honor Code, being a clear deviation from the established procedures. The second deliberation should be considered null and void." Yun yung kine-claim ng mga lawyer para kay Jack. Kasi nga, ang pinipirmahan ng mga kadete ay maliwanag line per line, provision per provision. And in so doing, ang ano doon, kung binago yung procedure, di ba meron ding violation yung committee themselves? Bakit nila ipo-force yung guilty na vote na 9-0 kahit meron ng 8-1 or 7-2 or 6-3? Sa susunod na video, magbibigay ko ng example ng 6-3 na nangyari. Okay, so dangerous yun. Kasi sinasabi mo on one side, okay, pagka nagbotohan tayo, yun yung ginagaranti ng ano natin, ng pinirmahan nating sistema, ng inayunan nating sistema lahat sa Cadet Corps, sinasabi ninyo, isang dissenting vote, okay na. So, siyempre, yung kadete sabihin, meron akong padrino dyan sa Honor Committee na magboboto sa akin not guilty. Tapos yung proseso nga, exhaustive deliberation, didinigin lahat. So, bakit matapos nyong kausapin yung mga witness, supposed to be, nawala yung aking ano. Bakit biglang ninyong ibabayol, kayo-kayo mismo, magkakaroon kayo ng chambering. Paano kung kunyari, kasundo nyo nga yung kadete na na-8-1? Wala ng chambering. So, is there anything written na at any point in time during the deliberation and then the votation, yung talagang boto, is there a written provision that the chairman, in this case si Kadet Khan, can stand up and say to the chamber? Meron bang ganon? Dapat naka-express yun dun sa provision in such cases wherein the 6-3, the 7-2, or 8-1 guilty and not guilty verdict is arrived at, meaning to say it's a not guilty verdict, the chairman can stand up and say to the chamber, and the voting members can now proceed to the chamber, to the executive session, without the recorders. So, may mga point. So, what's the number one? Ano para kay pa yung sinasabing one dissenting vote? Eh, pagka hindi mo konsunadin kadete, babanatan ka ng to the chamber. Tama ba? So, dapat, kung titignan mo maigi, yung spirit nung pagkakagawa ng mga provisions ng implementation ng honor code and system, dapat hindi na nilagay yun. Na, isa pa, secret ballot. Bakit kinakailang explain ng voting member yung boto niya? Secret ballot nga eh. What's the essence of secret ballot? So that you will not be pressured. So, bakit may chambering to pressure you to change your vote? Bakit may sinasabing dissenting vote na 8-1, not guilty ka na? You just need one dissenting vote to be acquitted. So, bakit pagka 8-1 na yung boto, o 7-2, o 6-3, eh, to the chamber. Ngayon, meron bang written na sub-provision na sinasabi, pwede mag-chamber, tapos nun, kailan hindi mag-chamber? Kasi magkakaroon ng favoritism. Pagka konsunada nila yung kadete, 8-1, tapos na ang buto-buto. Pagka hindi nila konsunada yung kadete, pangit, o kaya, kinakaingitan nila, o kaya whatever reason for that matter, to the chamber. And then paglabas, 9-0. Walang recorder doon sa loob. So, bakit? Bakit ina-uphold yung ganong sistema, yung ganong diskarte? It is violative mismo of the code. Naglolokohan lang tayo. Sino naglalay dito? Sino nag-cheat dito? Imagine, hindi mo nakuha sa deliberation yung mapalabas mong guilty yung kadete, kukuhanin mo sa secret chambering at ipe-pressure yung bumoto ng guilty, paglabas, 9-0, guilty na. Di ba violation ng honor code yun? So bakit yung kadete na sinacharge nila, pinipilit nila, violator ka, sinungaling ka, cheater ka, liar ka, ganon, magnanakaw ka. When you have a committee not respecting mismo the tenets of the honor code. Yun ang punto. Mga P-Mayor, yun ang punto. Ay, nako. Sana may chambering pa, no? Wala nang papasok sa academy pagka ganyang may chambering pa. Ay, nako. Anong klase kayo? Okay. Puso. Sana tayo. So, dapat daw null and void. Yun ang sinasabi ng mga petitioner. Petitioners further contend that the requirement of unanimous vote involves a substantive right which cannot be unceremoniously changed without a corresponding amendment/revision in the Honor Code and Honor System Handbook. Correct. It's logical. Sino ba? Akala, di ba, by the cadets, for the cadets, and of the cadets. Eh, bakit yung Honor Committee lang ang pwedeng magbago? Na sila-sila lang, hindi approved na commandant ng superintendent. Hindi approved. So, It's very dangerous when you have 17 to 25 year old people, cadets, na labeled as honor committee. Eh, nababago nila yung sistema haphazardly na nang walang nakakaalam. Sila-sila lang ang nagbabago. And that's dangerous, really. Okay. Dangerous talaga. So, in their view, sabi ng mga petitioner, chambering totally defeats the purpose of voting by secret ballot as it glaringly destroys the very essence and philosophy behind the provisions of the honor system. Yun ang sinasabi ko. Not only, mali sila rito, not only the system, the code itself, lie, cheat, steal, tolerating. Okay? Hindi lang yung mga iba sasabihin, sistema lang ang inaano. No! It goes side by side, the code and the system. The system is just there to implement the code. Pagka hindi mo in-implement yung system, there's a violation. Kaya nga nare-report ng guilt ng violation of the code. So, if you violate the system, and in this case, ang alleged violation is from the honor committee themselves, aba, merong problema. And hindi porke honor committee representative ikaw o ako, it means we are more honorable than the rest of the cadet corps. Ha? Ulitin ko, hindi porke honor committee representative kayo o chairman o ako, eh, mas honorable tayo dun sa cadet corps. No. No, 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 no. Nagkataon lang, kinakailangan, somebody gets the bad news, ikaw ang representante ng mga kaklasmate mo sa honor committee, kaya ikaw naging honor committee member. Not necessarily ikaw ay mas honorable, ha? Tandaan nyo yan. The honor committee members are only empowered by the members of the class that voted them per company. Okay? So, it does not follow that they are more honorable. Okay? Okay. Okay, the very essence and philosophy behind the provisions of the honor system, which is to ensure that the voting member is free to vote what is in his heart and mind, that no one can pressure or persuade another to change his or her vote. Hindi pwedeng baguhin, hindi ka pwedeng pressurein. Yun yung spirit and philosophy behind the provision. They suggest, yung mga petitioner, that if one voting member acquits an accused cadet who is obviously guilty of the offense, the solution is to remove him or her from the honor committee through the vote of non-confidence and as provided for in the honor code. Yun yung sinasabi ko sa mga previous vlogs. So, naintindihan ng mga lawyer ni Cadet Jack yung sistema. And then, the above arguments, respondents contend that a distinction must be made between the concepts of the honor code and the honor system. Pinaghihiwalay ngayon nila ng mga PMA authorities. Honor code, eto. Honor system, eto. Pinaghihiwalay. According to them, the respondents, the former sets the standard for a cadet's minimum ethical and moral behavior and does not change. Correct, I agree. While the latter, yung system, is a set of rules for the conduct of the observance and implementation of the honor code and may undergo necessary adjustments as may be warranted by the incumbent members of the honor committee in order to be more responsive to the moral training and character development of the cadets. Okay yung reasoning, but not so fast. But bago mo paguhin yan, ipaprove mo. Paprove mo para hindi mapaso yung command. At para fair dun sa mga kadete, remember, you were only empowered by these cadets who voted you to become members. Huwag kayong gawa ng changes na hindi alam ng cadet corps. No, nabubulaga yung mga cadets on trial na paano ko naging guilty? Hindi, na-chamber ka eh. Na-chamber ka, kawawa naman ano. Now, sinasabi ng mga academy lawyers na yung depensa nila, hiwala yung code, hiwala yung sistema. Ito, pang-implement lang and can change over time. Oh, sige, I give it to you. Pero, it does not say na pwede nilang i-violate yung mismong code na dapat i-implement nitong sistema. Si Cadet Jack lang ba ang nag-violate ng code? Sa tingin ng mga tao, questionable pa nga yun eh. Ang mas nag-violate ng code dito is yung mismong honor committee. Because they were lying, they were cheating on the results. And when they rendered the report, nakalagay doon 9-0 guilty, walang mention of an 8-1 or a 7-2 or a 6-3 verdict. Na initial verdict, which is already a deviation. Kasi ang sabi, pagka nagbotohan, after exhaustive discussion, tapos na. Tapos wala na explanation, kaya nga secret ballot eh. O bakit biglang may chambering and then, ang labas 9-0, guilty. Yung binotohan na 6-3, guilty. Yung binotohan ng 7-2, guilty. At yung 8-1, guilty. Ay, Diyos mio. So who is violating the code? The cadet on trial or the honor committee mismo? And the people there are tolerating. Sino mas malinis? Parang yan yung ano eh, yung recent na kwento kay Sam. Oh, sino supposed to be mag-implement ng batas? Yung PNP, yung police. O eh, bakit nagkaganoon? Si Sam pa yung kinasuhan. Siya pa yung ngayon guilty na kung ano-ano sino allegations nila. Siya pa ngayon yung suspect. Di ba? And this is the danger. That is the danger in real life when you have people na binabago yung sistema in the middle of the game. And it became tradition, as I will tell you in the succeeding blocks, it became tradition. And now the court is upholding that tradition. Wow! Wow, 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 wow. Problema tayo. That's why we have to speak up. Sorry, wag kayo ma-stress. Wag kayo ma-stress. Okay. Imagine that. The Honor Code may provide guidelines. The Honor Committee may provide guidelines when the honor system can be used to supplement regulations. This being so, the voting process is continuously subject to change. Huh? The voting process is continuously subject to change. Ah, tapos na, buto-buto, sinabi ng Korte Suprema eh. Nang kinakampihan ng Korte Suprema respondent, ano mangyayari? Di ba? Kaya pala na ano eh, hindi nakagraduate eh. Respondents note that historically, imagine inaamin na nila, is tradition already. Respondents note that historically, a non-unanimous guilty verdict automatically acquits a cadet from the charge of honor violation. So, merong 8-1, 7-2, historically, ano na siya? Acquitted na. the voting members only write their guilty or not guilty verdict, gaya ng pinakita ko sa inyo, in the voting sheets without stating their name or their justification. However, this situation drew criticism since there were instances where a reported cadet already admitted his honor violation but was acquitted due to the lone vote of a sympathetic voting member. Oh, so why justify chambering? Ang sinasabi ng mga respondents, inamin na ng kadete, yes sir, I violated the code. Yes sir, I'm guilty of lying or cheating or stealing or tolerating. Tapos, nung nagbotohan, inamin na nga nung tao on trial, sa harap ng honor committee, nung nagbotohan, not guilty. Okay, yun ba yung depensa ng honor committee at ng command? Therefore, yung bumoto na not guilty, dapat yun yung tinanggal. Nag-vote of non-confidence. Kung ako yung chairman, I will find out, kagayong ginawa ng honor committee chairman ng either 81 or 82, pinind out nila kung sino yung lone dissenter palagi dun sa honor committee. No? Tinandaan yung papel na pagbobotohan nung suspect nila na yun lagi ang lone dissenter. O di nahuli. Oh. And then you can go through the process na vote of non-confidence. At kung hindi mo pa rin mahuli, edi palitan mo yung buong committee. Ganun lang yun. Pero yung papalitan mo yung spirit, yung sistema, yung philosophy ng provision na ganito ang promise sa kadete, mali yun, mga guys, mali yun, mga iho, mga sir, mali yun. Dinajustify ninyo yung kalokohan. Dalawa lang yun. Half empty, half filled na glass. Okay? Dito kayo lumalagay. Ako dito ko lumalagay. Eh, paano kung kunyari totoong nagbabiolate ng code yung honor committee? Paano na? Dinajustify ninyo yung honor committee? O di, tuloy-tuloy yan. Tuloy-tuloy yan. Eh, saan pupunta tayo? Saan pupunta ang academy? In the case of Cadet First Class Jack Arcadio, the Honor Committee adopted an existing practice, o inamin, adopted an existing practice that should the voting result in 7-2 or 8-1, sinungaling pa nga eh, pati 6-3, may katibay, may 6-3 pa nga eh, the Honor Committee would automatically sanction a jury type of discussion called executive session or chambering, which is intended to elicit the explanation and insights of the voting members. Oh, what happened dun sa exhaustive deliberation? Hindi kayo naniniwala sa sarili ninyong mga member, honor committee, academy, makinig kayo. Hindi naniniwala yung honor committee na sa truthfulness ng mga members ng honor committee, yung voting members, such that they have to undergo a second deliberation, a second votation. Hindi na nga botohan yun eh. Pinepressure na lang kung sino yung nagboto o umamin ka kasi nakalagay na ngayon doon sa voting sheet, pirmado kung sino yung not guilty. So, ang daming binago. This prevents the tyranny, it prevents the tyranny of the minority or the lone dissenter from prevailing over the manifest proof of guilt. Stupid! That's stupid. This prevents the tyranny of the lone dissenter? No! A lone dissenter may be the 11th man when everybody else is saying guilty, guilty, guilty. Baka siya lang ang may wisdom. Mali yung utak ninyo. Mali. Dapat ang ano dyan, excuse me, ang nirerespeto yung lone dissenter. So kung kaya nga dapat hindi explain. Pero kung yung sinasabi yung case, na inamin na guilty na siya, eh, hindi pa ako maniniwala doon sa sinasabi ninyo eh. Dapat ang naging ano ng korte, no? Cite to me the specific cadet, okay? Produce nyo yung specific cadet na umamin, na ginilty ninyo, tapos noon nag-8-1, may nag-dissenting vote. Cite to me the, ibigay nyo sa akin yung recordings at panonoorin naming mga judge. Yung lahat nung yung trial na yon na sinasabi ninyo na merong instance in the past na guilty na nga yung tao, tapos inamin na nga niya sa buong committee, yes, I committed, ay may ano is guilty. And then meron pang nag-dissenting vote. Bakit yung nag-dissenting vote ang iniisip nyo lagi? If there's a case and then a trial na may dissenting vote, lone dissenting vote, sasabihin ninyo, tyranny of the minority. Mga walang ya ang ano, walang ya yung ganong, mali yung ganong yung utak na yung majority. No, mali na yung system, mali na yung ano, pagkakaintindi nyo sa honor, mali na yung pagkakaintindi nyo sa code. When everybody thinks na someone is guilty, a cadet who has wisdom and open-minded and pragmatic yung ano niya, yung view niya. Remember, he's an honor committee representative and therefore, and still a cadet. Ang premise is, he understands the whole thing, the whole scenario, and he is honorable just like everybody else. He respects your vote na kung walo kayo, he respects your vote na guilty. Respetuhin dapat yung boto niya na not guilty. Pero wag niyo sasabihin na ano siya? Na lang niya yan. Criminal siya. Na tyranny of the minority. The assailed voting practice has been adopted and widely accepted by PMA blank blank 20XX yung class nila since their first year in the academy. Eh yun nga, naging tradisyon na. So minana pa nila. So before them, meron na. Actually nga, sabi ko nga sa inyo, when I traced it, it happened somewhere in the mid-90s. The allegations of the conspiracy and sham trial are therefore negated by the fact that such practice was in place and applied to all cases of honor violations, not solely to the case of Cadet First Class Jack Arcadio. That's the point. Naging tradisyon na, pero that not necessarily mean na tama yon. Sinasabi nga ngayon na mali yon, mali. Ever since, so, hindi po, inaano ang depensa nila, hindi lang si Cadet Jack Arcadio. O yun, inamin nyo, ang dami na palang kadeteng naging biktima ng kayo yung tyranny, no? Kayo yung tyranny of the majority. Wag ka, hindi dapat ganun ang minana na lang namin 'yan. Parang yung sinabi ni General Reyes, we walked into this, yung pabaon system. O di, yun na nga yung punto ni Senator, no? Sundalong kanin ni Senator Ek-Ek na hindi porke you walk into it, that is the right thing to do. You could have done something about it, which I agree. Kasi kung titignan mo yung two basic questions, and if you really have that honor practice in your life, did I intend to deceive? Did I intend to take undue advantage? You walked into it, merong pabaon na 48 million. Wow, sarap nito ah, 48 million, libre. But that is taxpayers' money, that there is something wrong. Na ikaw ang chief of staff, you should have corrected it. Diba? Hindi yung, hindi, minana ko na yan eh, ganyan na yan. I walked into it, it's a practice. Hindi nga eh, may mali. So, ganun din na sinasabi nitong mga bata, na, teka muna, nung plebo kami, ganyan eh. So, we walked into it, yan na yung practice. Ngayon, yung academy, tinayuan yan.
No, pati yung korte, tinayuan yan. Ngayon, sinong loko-loko? Sinong mali? Diba? We want to be governed by rules. We want to be governed with the truth, no? At saka yung tama. Pero wag naman yung ganito. Uphold. Justify na dinaanan na namin yan. Kasi ano yan, mali. Dinaanan na namin yan, minana na namin yan, ibig ko sabihin. So, ganyan yung practice. But that does not justify na dapat ituloy niyo yung practice. Parang hazing yan eh. Dinaanan na namin yan, binubuntal na kami eh. May hazing na sa academy. Pero gustong-gusto niyong tanggalin yung hazing. Diba? So, ganito rin to eh. Gusto mong tanggalin yung practice kasi mali. Gusto mong tanggalin yung hazing kahit minana mo na yan. 1950s, 60s pa yan. Hanggang ngayon, may namamatay pa. Tinatanggal. Pero yun nga, pagka ginajustify kasi yung mali, lalong nagiging tradisyon na. And yan ang mangyayari. So kung ito hindi tutuwid, ay nako, tuloy-tuloy pa rin yung may mga kadeteng mamalasin, may mga, at laging yung academy will be dragged into a national ek-ek ng mga issue, paglalaroan kayo ng media at SOCMED, and then continuously kayong maglalay, magsisinungaling kayo just to cover up and save your image, your credibility as an institution. And that is wrong. You do not save yourself, your name, your credibility, your image by stating na tama yung ginagawa nitong mga luko-lukong to na nagkamali. Kaya nga frustrating. Buti na lang wala ako sa serbisyo. Sorry. It is it is emphasized by respondents that any decision to change vote rests solely on the personal conviction of the dissenters. Talaga? Matapos yung i-pressure, may choice pa siya na baguhin or may choice siya na i-retain yung kanyang ano, yung kanyang boto? Matapos yung konsensyahin, matapos yung ganyanin, duruin? Ay, nako. Matapos yung i-threaten. Natatanggalin mo siya sa club. Without any compulsion from the other voting members. Talaga? Sana may recorder sa loob. Eh bakit walang recorder? Oh, kung tama yung ginagawang chambering, bakit ito trial na supposedly tama and may recorder, merong nagsusulat ng minutes of the trial, and then, bakit doon sa chambering, wala na? So, ang assumption ko, meron kayong niluluto doon sa loob. Meron kayong maling ginagawa kasi ayaw nyo dalhin yung recorder sa loob. Academy, kung yung chambering, ginajustify ninyo, then make it a point, no? Make it a point. Pati recorder nandun sa loob and it's recorded. And then, the whole thing, it is reported. Pagka nag-transmit sila ng Honor Committee Report, the final Honor Committee Report, ilagay ninyo, require ninyo yung Honor Committee na ilagay doon na 7-2, and then nag-chambering, o 8-1, nag-chambering, 6-3, nag-chambering, and then 9-0. Then merong record kung ano nangyari doon sa loob. Makikita mo ngayon kung sinong mainay doon, kung sino yung nangaroon na, hindi, bakit hindi mo ginilty? Giltihin mo! Ganon-ganon ba? Diba? Wag na kayong mag-reason out na mga officers ng academy, ano? Or alam niyo namang mali yung ginawa niyo. Kung ganyan ang PM mayor, kayo na lang ang maging PM mayor. Nakakaano yan, nakakasuka. That's hypocritical. Sasabihin natin, honorable tayo, tapos nang justify ninyo yung act na hindi honorable. to the bank commander. Somebody, muntik na. Somebody's statements, yung kanyang affidavit, no? Respondents raised the argument that the fact-finding board / investigating body summoned cadet first class Laglag for inquiry. So yung tinawag siya nung investigating body na inappoint ng academy. Yun yung crab. Aside from his oral testimony made under oath. Uy, nag-under oath si Cadet Laglag. He submitted to the board body an affidavit explaining that sometime on 23rd or 24th of January 2018, I went to the Department of Naval Warfare to ask permission if it is possible not to attend the Navy duty for the reason that I will be attending our baseball game outside the academy. So, core squad pala to, si Cadet Laglag. Number 12, nagsimula si 11. So, number 12, after I was permitted not to attend my Navy duty and when I was about to exit out of the office, Commander... Commander somebody, Philippine Navy, our head Department of Naval Warfare officer, called my attention. I approached him and he said, talagang nadali si Arcadio ah. Ano ba talaga ang nangyari? Tapos sabi niya, at first I was hesitant to answer because of the confidentiality of the honor committee proceedings. Confidential, pero nagsalita ka. He again said,
huwag kang mag-alala. Atin-atin lang ito. Alam ko naman na bawal magsabi.
Then I answered, ako yung isang not guilty, sir. May confidentiality, pero ako yung not guilty, sir. Nagpasikat pa, eh, no? Ako yung not guilty, sir. Kaya, yung presiding officer nagsabi na pumunta muna kami sa chamber. Chamber muna. Kung nung nasa chamber kami, nagsalita yung mga nag-vote ng guilty. Tapos isa-isa nagsabi kung bakit ang boto nila guilty. Eh, wala akong pakialam sa inyo. Eh, di ginilty nyo nga ninyo eh. Bakit tinakailan justify ninyo pa yung guilty? Nung pakinggan ko, eh, naliwanagan ako. Wow! Hallelujah! Hallelujah! Oh, naliwanagan. Pinalitan ko yung boto ko from not guilty to guilty, sir, he replied. Sayang si Arcadio, ano? And I said, oo nga, sir. Sayang si Arcadio. Mabait pa naman at matalino. Eh, gago ka pala eh. Napaninindigan. Kaya nga laglag eh. Cadet First Class Laglag restated the above in the counter-affidavit executed on March 12, 2014, days before the graduation to, no? Which he submitted before the Committee on Human Rights. So, natakot na sila sa human rights. Nandyan eh. Pumasok na sa loob ng academy. Nag-imbestiga na eh. Wherein he attested to the following. Matakot din kayo sa human rights. 3.1. 3. I was chosen to be a voting member of the Honor Committee for Honor Code Violation committed by Cadet Jack for lying. As a voting member, we are the one who assess or investigate the case whether the reported cadet is guilty for his actions or not. Number 4, I was the only one who initially voted not guilty among the 9 voting members of the Honor Committee in the case of Cadet Arcadio for lying. Inamin niya, ako lang bumoto ng not guilty. 5. I initially voted not guilty for the reason that after the proceedings and before the presiding officer told the members to vote, I was confused of the case of cadet. Nung ng presiding officer, presiding chairman, is everything clear? O di kung confused ka, dapat ginanyan mo. Hindi pa ako maliwanag. Ganun kasimple. No? It means you are all incompetent lahat sa Honorcom. Hindi maliwanag, meron pang guilty, meron pang confused na member, ba't kayo magbobotohan? Di ba? Dapat tinaas niya yung kamay. Ba't sinasarili lang yan? It means, you have a voting member who is incompetent. Hindi alam yung gagawin. Okay. I have gathered some facts from the investigation to make my decision, but for me, it is not yet enough to give my verdict of guilty to Cadet Arcadio. So I decided to vote not guilty. With a reservation in my mind, parang nasa hotel siya, may reservation, in my that we will still be discussing our verdicts if we will arrive at 8-1 or 7-2. Thus, I can still change my vote if I may be enlightened with the others' justifications. Mga sir, lahat na naging member ng Honor Committee sa Academy, noon, noong pa hanggang ngayon, yung, kahit yung mga patay na, bumangon kayo sa inyong libingan. At tignan nyo itong explanation na ito. Bumoto siya na not guilty kasi hindi pa malinaw. Okay? That statement, in fact, is very clear. Hindi pa klaro, hindi klaro na mag-guilty siya. Kaya bumoto ko ng not guilty. Up to that point, tama yung ginagawa niya. Not guilty kasi hindi klaro eh. Ngayon, hinihintay pa niya na pagka nag-8-1, meron namang practice na procedure na wala sa Honor Committee provisions. Yung practice, inaasahan niya na pagka nagkaroon ng 7-2 or 8-1, mag-chamber. And then, sigurado, guilty na. Magpapalitan na. Tanong. Was there any case or trial in the history of the Honor Committee na whatever was the result, initial result ng botohan, 6372 or 81, na pagka nag-chamber kayo, ang naging resulta ay not guilty? O yung nag-chamber kayo, ang resulta lahat guilty? Kasi pagka ganun, eh talaga may problema kayo. At bakit kinakailangan nga mag-chamber? Bakit hindi na lang doon, right there in the open, nakaharap lahat ng vote, lahat ng ano, members na present, at may mga recorder, at may video na may camera, na transparent lahat. And then, aalis kayo doon, and then papasok ko sa isang secret room, executive session kayo. Ginagaya niyo yung Senado. Public hearing and then pagka merong issue, executive session. Ano ba kayo, senador? Wala kayo sa media. Kadete pa lang kayo, hindi kayo senador. Mga loko-loko. Alak ng toko, mga... Number 6. Hindi pa. With reservation in my mind that will arrive at 8-1 or 7-2, pwede pang magkaroon ng chambering. I can still change my vote if I may be enlightened with the others' justifications. My man, mga Honor Committee reps, you're playing with cadets' lives. Dinedesisyon na ninyo, mga sir, ang buhay ng isang kadete. Bakit nyo po puwersahin yung boto na guilty? Ano ba yun? May quota ba kayo? Mali yung ginagawa nyo. Okay. After the votes were collected, the presiding officer told us that the vote is 8 guilty, 1 not guilty. Oh, ano yung sinasabi ng command? Walang 8-1 na guilty. Sinabi o national TV. Ito, inaamin na nga nila. Hindi nila maano eh, kasi mape-perjure sila na, sa human rights eh, no? 8-1 not guilty. 8 guilty, 1 not guilty. By way of practice and as I predicted, we were told to go inside the anteroom for executive meeting and to discuss our respective justifications. So what happened to the secret ballot? Na alam na ng lahat ng voting members kung ano yung naging boto ng bawat isa. And then in-explain ng bawat isa. Paano naging secret ballot yon? Na pinagmamalaki ninyo sa inyong mga sinumpang salaysay na secret ballot yan. You even fooled the Supreme Court.
Okay.
So, tradition na siya by way of practice. Abe, and as I predicted, manghuhula to si Kadet Laglag. I have been a member for 2 years and the voting committee will always go for executive meeting whenever it will meet 8-1 or 7-2 votes. That is alarming. Okay? That is very alarming. Cadet Corps, you stand up to this. Baguhin nyo to. Kung ayaw ng command baguhin, kayo mismo, Cadet Corps, baguhin nyo to. Mali itong ganitong practice. Pagtatanggalin nyo yung buong honor committee, palitan ninyo. And make sure your rights are upheld. The code is upheld as well as your rights. Practice yan. Hindi sinasabi na you're being less honorable. No. You all protect the honor code. You protect the honor system. What is written in that honor system? The spirit of the honor code and system. Pagka alam yung mali, abay, ikorike ninyo. Huwag kayong matakot sa honor committee. You can always change the honor committee representative because you were the ones, cadets per class, per company, who empowered the honor committee. Okay? You call for a voting na tanggalin nyo yung mga abusado. Mga ang tatapang ng mga yan. Parang walang kamatayan. Bugbugin nyo. Joke. Ay, nako. Tatapang eh. 7. I listen to them and they listen to me. Oh, ba't na bago yung boto mo? I listen to them and they listen to me. Then I saw things that enlightened my confusions that time. I gave a thumbs up sign and asked for another sheet of voting paper. Eh, kinumpleto mo yung voting paper na yun sa labas na eh. Outside of the trial na. Sa barracks mo na. Inaccomplice. Aminin. I then changed my vote from not guilty. O sinong lying dito? I then changed my vote from guilty to guilty and the voting members of the honor committee came up with the final vote of 9 votes for guilty and 0 votes for not guilty. Oh, sino ngayon yung quibbling dito? Sino ngayon yung nag-half-truth, nagbibigay ng half-truth? Kailan mo binigay, kailan mo pinirman, kailan mo inaccomplish yung boto mo na guilty? Sa barracks na. Hindi doon sa session, hindi doon sa chamber. Because, sabi, ang testimony ng ibang kadete, nung aking mga witness, you accomplish it in barracks. Kadet Laglag. Okay. Hey. Number 9, Kadet Jack was called inside the courtroom and told that the verdict was guilty of lying. After that, all persons inside the courtroom went back to barracks. Cadet Jack was informed of the verdict, guilty of lying. Imagine after nyong sabihin a few minutes ago, Cadet Jack, do you know how we vote here? Just to remind you, you need one dissenting vote. Hindi nyo alam yung sinasabi nyo. Kaka-remind nyo lang sa kanya, you need one dissenting vote.
to be acquitted, we need unanimous 9-0 for you to be guilty.
Eh, chinamber ninyo eh. Meron na nga 1 dissenting vote. O bakit? Ano yun? Sinong lying doon? Tapos ipipilit nyo siya yung lying. Aba, ano yan? Honor system, one way. Kadete lang ang pwedeng matry, pwedeng magilty. Yung honor committee, hindi.
Number 10, right after I changed to sleeping uniform, I was approached by cadet. Sino to? Oh. Jack Arcadio and cadet Noel inquiring and said, bakit ka naman nagpagalit ng nagpalit ng boto? I answered, nasa process yan. May mali talaga sa rason mo. They also asked who were inside the chamber and I mentioned Cadet Khan, Cadet ano. The last time that Cadet Arcadio and Cadet Noel talked to me, that was the last time. Oye, galit sa'yo eh. Wala kang prinsipyo. Wala kang ano, nilaglag mo eh. Wala kang balls. Sometime on 23rd and 24th January 2014, I went to the Department of Naval Warfare to ask permission if it's possible not to attend the Navy duty for the reason that I will be attending our baseball game. Ayun, yun na yun. Dinebunk niya ngayon yung sinabi ni Commander somebody. After I was permitted not to attend my Navy duty and I was about to exit our office, Commander somebody, our head Department Naval Warfare, called my attention. Yun nga. Talagang nadali si Arcadio ah. Ano pa talaga nangyari? At first, I was hesitant to answer because of the confidentiality. Huwag ka mag-alala, atin-atin lang ito. Alam ko naman na bawal. No? Sinabi ko na yung kanina, umulit eh. Still not to be outdone, petitioners argue that the very fact that Cadet First Class Laglag as the lone dissenter was made to explain in the presence of other honor committee members who were in disagreement with him gives a semblance of intimidation, force, or pressure. Gestapo nga eh. For them, the records of the honor committee proceedings which were not presented assuming they actually exist, assuming they were actually, sabi ng court ah, assuming they actually exist, could have been the best way to ensure that he was free to express his views, reject the opinion of the majority, and stick to his decision. Also, it was pointed out that Cadet First Class Laglag failed to clearly explain in his affidavit why he initially found Cadet First Class Arcadio not guilty. And what made him change his mind? His use of general statements like he was confused of the case and so things that enlightened my confusions could hardly suffice to establish why he changed his vote. Finally, petitioners note the admission of Cadet First Class Laglag during the CHR investigation that he was the only one who was given another ballot sheet while in the chamber and that he accomplished it in the barracks, which he only submitted the following day. However, as the CHR found, the announcement of 9-0 vote was done immediately after the honor committee came out of the chamber before Cadet Laglag submitted his accomplished ballot sheet. Ay. Sabi ng korte, we rule for respondents. So, kumampi sila sa respondents. Okay. As to the manner of voting by the honor committee members, sabi ng court, the honor code tersely provides. After a thorough discussion and deliberation, yun yung sinabi ng ano ng sistema. The presiding member of the board will call for the members to vote whether the accused is guilty or not. A unanimous vote or 9 votes of guilty decides what a cadet is whether decides that a cadet is found guilty of violating the honor code. So in this case, kung susundan mo yung ano na yon, yung paragraph na yon, Eh, nung sinabing 8-1, not guilty, anong resulta?
For the above provision, quoted provision, it readily appears that the honor committee practice of conducting executive session or chambering is not at all prohibited. Imagine, the Supreme Court is telling us, wala naman nakalagay doon, bawal yung executive session. Eh, di pwede. Hello? For the above question provision, yung provision kasi, after a thorough discussion and deliberation. Ano ba yung thorough discussion and deliberation? Eh, wala naman nagsabi na isang beses lang yan, o dalawa, o tatlo eh. Oh. Ay, nako. Eh, ang hirap kasi pagka gumagamit ka ng ano na eh, ng palusot eh. Ang sinasabi si Cadet Arcadio nagpalusot. Hindi eh. Nagpapalusot mga tao eh. After a thorough discussion and deliberation, the presiding member of the board will call for the members to vote whether the accused is guilty or not guilty. A unanimous vote of guilty decides that a cadet is found guilty of violating the honor code. So the court says, from the above quoted provision, it really appears that the honor committee practice of conducting executive session or chambering is not at all prohibited. Uy, hindi siya bawal. The honor committee is given leeway on the voting procedures in actual cases, taking into account the exigency of the times. What is important is that in the end, there must be a unanimous 9 votes in order to hold the cadet guilty of violating the honor code. So parang sinabi ninyo, okay lang na pwersahin yung 9-0? Okay lang ha? Okay lang yun? Okay lang? So, granting for argument's sake that the honor committee violations is written procedure, we will still rule that there is nothing internally wrong with the practice of chambering. So, yun ang sabi ng korte. Okay. So, kayo musga. Nakaka-stress, ano? Okay, ma-stress. So, yun yung ano ng korte. Kayong mag-comment kayo. Magsabi kayo, opinion nyo. Cool lang. Happy Sunday. Maraming salamat. God bless everyone. Like, share, subscribe. Bye-bye.